Hello, welcome to Sai Jaini Academy channel. ARM controller calculate the effective address. Today we will discuss calculate the effective address of the following instruction. If register R3 is equal to 0x4000 and register R4 is equal to 0x, x represents hexadecimal 20. So here is the instruction STRH. R9 comma within a square bracket R3 comma R4. Find the effective address of the following. So here what happens? R9 is equal to R3 plus R4. So R3 is holding is equal to R3 is holding 0x4000 plus R4 holding 0x20 is equal to 0x4020. This is the effective address of this instruction. Storing data in this memory location 0x4020. This is the effective address we have given here, 4020. This is the effective address we have given, 40. Next thing, LDRB, B represent byte, this H represent half word. So what happens here? What happens to this? Here it is equal to R8 is equal to R3 plus R4 into multiply LSL hash 3 means it is a 2 to the power of 3, it means 8. So the content of R4 multiply with 8 and it is added with R3 to get effective address of the R8. What is this? What happens here? So for this initial value is 4000 because it is a R3 is 0x40. Second value, R4 is shifted multiplied with 8 means it is a 100, 100. Here is the question arises, how it is 100? For that I am trying to solve this with the help of the shifting operations. Here is, I have taken this value 0x20. Already you know that 0x, the content of R4 is 0x20. 0x20. It means we can represent this value 0, 0 for this 0, 2 for this value, this is the 2. And I have taken another nibble or 4 digits here. Okay, this is nothing but a 0x20. You got it. Now I will shift this one bit to left side. What happened? Its value? Its value becomes 040, or you can say 0x40. You can write it in this way. This is 4, this is 0. This is nothing but 0x40. And the second time, if you shift the bit to this left side, what happened? This value become 0x80. Got it? So here is the position you can represent. This nibble represents your 0. This is 8. So it is 0x80. Now if you multiply or shift another position, it goes to this position. From this point to next digit, then it has become 1. This whole thing has become 1. This whole thing becomes 0. This whole thing becomes 0. Then it is 0x100. 100, not a 100, it is a 100. Finally, what is the effective address of this instruction? That is the main important, that is what we are going to discuss now. Okay, after left shift the content of R4, what is the content of R4? Content of R4 is 20, 0x20. That's why we have taken this 20. So, okay, that 20 shifted 3 position to get this 0x100, 100. It is not a 100, it is a 0, 100. So, if I put this value here for this equation, R8 is equal to R3. R3 means 4000, 0x4000. This content become 0x100. Now this value become 0x4000 plus 0x100. It is nothing but 0x4100. That's what the answer we have given here. This is nothing but the effective address of this instruction is effective address, EA means effective address R3 plus R4 into 8. It is nothing but 0x4100. I hope you all understood what happens here. Next instruction is LDR. Please remember, if you say LDR, it is a 32 bit value. Here is LDR B means it is a 8 bit or byte. This H represents, this is the half word. In case of ARM, ARM is a 32 bit processor. Half word means it is a 16 bit. Got it? This is what the difference between half word, byte and LDR. We doesn't have any H or B, so it is a 32 bit instructions. please remember. Here are four, here LDR R7 comma square bracket R3 comma R4. What is the answer we are expecting? What's the answer? First, it will take the value, it's a post indexing. This is what the post indexing we say. This is what the post indexing. Post indexing means first it will take this value. That's why it is R7. First it will, what it will do, it will take this value, that is R3 is equal to this value. This is the effective address for this instruction. After execution of this, it will add this value. This is what we called as post indexing. I hope you all understood what is the post indexing. First, its effective address is R7. Effective address of R7 is equal to R3. Why it is R3? Because it is a post indexing. Its value is equal to 0x400. Get it? That's why its value is 4000, not a 4020. Why it is not a 4020? It is a post indexing. That's why R7 takes the effective address of this. This address it will take first. After doing this, taking this value, it will add this value. So this is called the post indexing addressing. Post index addressing modes, we can say. Next we index instruction, we are trying to solve. What is there in that? This is another instruction. What it says? The fourth one, strb, it is a store instruction. This is a byte. What happens here? What is the effective address again? For this also, the effective address is R3 only. Why it is R3? It is a post indexing instruction. First it will take this address. Afterwards it will consider this value. That's why the R6 effective address for this instruction, R6 is equal to R3. That's why we have given this answer. This is the effective address for this instruction R5. Got the point? This is again a post indexing. First it will take this value. Afterwards it adds remaining. That's why the effective address for this R6, again it is R3, that is 0x4000. So this instruction is post indexing. This instruction also post indexing. We have another instruction, that is LDR LDR R0 comma square bracket R3 comma minus R4 comma LSL 3, LSL hash 3. It is nothing but a 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 3, it means 8. 8 is multiplied with this value. Okay, we already done that, I think. Or 4, yes, we done here. This is the process. This is done already. So, this is what we say the posting, pre-indexing method of addressing modes. This is the pre-index addressing modes. Again, what we did is, this is what the value we expected. We already discussed this. What we have to do? We have to subtract this 100 with R3 minus this value. R3 is how much? 0x. R0 is equal to R3 minus subtraction will be there, because it is subtracted between these two register. So final result of R4 is 100 is equal to 4000 0x 4000 minus 0x 100 is equal to what we will get? Go to here, take the calculator. I'll choose a hexadecimal. 0x 4000 minus 100, you will get 0f00. 0, what you will get? 0f00. I will do once again. 4000 minus 100, sorry, is equal to 3f00. You will get 3f00. This is the result we get for this instruction. Once again, so this way the effective address can be calculated in case of ARM. So once again I will repeat this one. This is a STRH, this is a STRS instruction. This instruction shows that it is a pre-indexing. It will add this value and it is the effective address of this. This is again a pre-index addressing mode. Again, we'll do all these things before it consider as a effective address. R8 is equal to R3 plus R4 into 8. 8 means 2 to the power of 3 position shift left, its value become 0x4100. The effective address of this is a post-indexing addressing mode. Here R7 is equal to R3. Why R3? It is a post-indexing. First it will take this value. After taking this value, it will consider add this value. Okay. This is what we will get. Again, here is the post-indexing, because R6 is nothing but R3. What is R3? R3 is again a 0x4000. Here what happens? There is a subtraction between these two. R3 and R4. R3 is 4000, R1 is 100. Hexadecimal, if you subtract this value, you will get 0x3F00. I hope it will help you. I hope. It will help you. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe our channel. This example refer from textbook ARM controller page 62, Sapna Sapna Publications.